Good morning, YouTube. So now I've got my new AC panel meter in the variable power supply here. I've plugged in the old panel meter into the new panel meter, and I just wanted to see what kind of power one of these panel meters takes. So this is the PZEM-061, and then plugged in over here I've got my PZEM-061, which was the original meter I had up here. And it looks like it's taking, 7 tenths of a watt, 0.04 or 40 milliamps. And my small clamp meter is saying about 45 milliamps. So yeah, there's the power consumption on one of these meters. Let's take a look at the meter and I'll show you what I'm measuring, how I'm measuring that. Okay, I've got the meter plugged in here. This is again the PZEM-061 that has the external current transformer, and I've got it plugged into my quick test with just a pair of wires for power, and then I've got the current transformer. What I've done is I've run one of the power wires for the meter through the current transformer, so the meter is actually measuring its own power consumption. And I get pretty close to the same reading. I get the 40 milliamps down here, and then this one's reading 0.5 watts, half a watt. The other meter's reading 0.7, so that's pretty close. Let me switch something around here and show you what changes here. That's what's nice about this quick test. You can just unplug your power. And what I'm going to do is take the wire out of the current transformer and we'll plug it back in. And so now I'm actually getting zeros. I didn't really test this particular meter outside of the power supply. I have a second meter. I used that to build my 220 volt kilowatt meter. And that one was always reading about 0.4 watts. And about the same 40 milliamps. And that one I tested externally with nothing in the current transformer, and I couldn't get it down to zero. But now this one is reading zero, which is interesting. Looks like these things are capable of reading down to zero, but they seem to be quite sensitive to any sort of magnetic field. What I'm thinking is perhaps the way the AC power supply was wired, and I didn't really look into that when I installed the meter. I just kind of found wire to run through the current transformer, and then I found the wires off the voltmeter. So I may have been picking up the current or the power that's used to operate this meter inadvertently, and could have been measuring its own power consumption, and that was what was throwing my meter off. But that is one advantage of running this meter with the external power supply modification, because then you're guaranteed that the power for the meter is coming from a separate source and not through the current transformer, so that's a little easier to control. But anyway, I got this meter, it's running, and I've got another project that I have in mind for this meter. These external current transformers make it a lot easier to wire up. You know, you don't have to cut any wires or anything. I think I want to put this on my 120 volt AC power inverter as a power output meter. But let me show you here, just to show you how similar these meters are. This is the PZEM-061, and it's got the same 1 microfarad capacitor. You've got your same connections over here. Yeah, and this one, the line connection is on the outside, and then your neutral is in the second position. So these positions of the wire power feed changes around a little bit. So here's your current transformer. On the current transformer versions, they have a half ohm resistor between these two pins. On the current shunt, they have a 1 milliohm resistor between these two pins. And you might notice I've got a couple of wires In there, the red wire here is attached to the positive of the liquid crystal backlight LED, and then the black wire is hooked to the negative terminal. You can easily find them if you pull the board out, flip it over, and there's basically two LED connections, one over here, and then there's one over here. And it looks like the one closest to the ST link is your positive connection, and then the one over here is the negative. What I did was I ran that over here to a little phono jack that I put in the top of the case, and then I have a small, this is a 2 to 5 volt buzzer. I tried a 4 to 15 volt buzzer. Unfortunately, that's not quite enough. This backlight LED only goes up to about 2.5 volts. So the reason I put those wires on, a couple of viewers had asked if there was a way to get an audio power alarm on this device, and the default behavior is that all it does is flash the LED backlight on and off. So I thought, how about adding a buzzer on there? And I don't have a power alarm on here, but I've got the backlight off. So that would simulate the power alarm. And that's just running off of this small piezoelectric buzzer. And then I have it on a 3.5 millimeter phono jack, so I can just unplug it. And in that case, then there's no sound. So yeah, if you want to add a buzzer to that, you just have to tap into these two terminals there, find the positive and negative, just use a voltmeter. And in fact, I think the 021 model actually had a plus and minus labeled on the backside of the circuit board. This one didn't have any markings. And again, you can set the power reading down to 100 watts. So it's tenths of kilowatts up to the maximum of the meter. And that's the sort of audible alarm you would get. Now, if you need to use the backlight with the alarm, what you could do is put a DC blocking capacitor. I tried, I think it was a 220 microfarad capacitor in here, and that'll pass through the AC voltage. You'll get kind of a sawtooth wave getting through to your buzzer. It does substantially cut down on the volume because you're not passing the full 2.5 volts to the buzzer, and the buzzer only works down to about 2 volts, so you just get a short blip. But what you could do is run that out as an audio signal here. You could run that audio signal out, play around with what size capacitor to run in there to get the desired amplitude sound wave, and then you could run it to an actual audio amplifier. And that would be handy if, for instance, you had this meter, say, in one room and you wanted the audio alarm in another room. You could run a shielded audio cable from the back of the meter and then plug that into, say, an amplified speaker, and it would broadcast that sound. Or you could probably even plug in a little Bluetooth audio transmitter and then broadcast that sound. So, yeah, there's a couple options for getting an audio power alarm on this meter. So I just thought I'd do that as a little exercise there. Yeah, if you have any other questions about these panel meters, I'll show you what once I figure out how I want to mount this on my AC power inverter, I'll show you what that looks like. But in the meantime, you can subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. And as always, thanks for watching.